Hey guys, this is Amy from Jack and Amy Dev, and we are going to look at how to pass the review process. Many of you have received the message, your product violates the use of permissions section of the policy. So we are going to be talking about individual permissions and see if you really need them. In this video, we are going to be talking about storage and his companion, unlimited storage. So let's see if we really need these. Let's get started. One of the fastest ways to find out if you are using the storage permission is to go ahead and do a search in your through your code and look for chrome.storage. Once you have found the file where you're using it, like for example here, chrome.storage.sync.set, you can write down your file name and the line number. So this would be options.js, line number 38. I am using it here to set whatever information you're doing. Or if you want to point out to line number six and say you are getting, in this case, it's the removed context menu and you're doing a bunch of things here. So make sure that if you find chrome.storage, then you precisely explain and help the team find exactly in what file and what line you're using it. So when we go to the storage API documentation, it's very tempting to see, oh, permission storage, and look at storage API, and we say, well, I guess I need it because I'm using storage API. But if we read a little bit more carefully, it says that this API provides the same storage capabilities as the local storage.api, which is the window.localStorage, but with these key differences. I'll include this link in the description below so you can read later. However, so this doesn't mean that you need storage to use local storage. If you are just storing very little information that you just want to have access to, and you are using local storage, that's fine, but you don't need to include the storage permission. So this may be a reason why you're being rejected. Another reason you do not need storage permission is if you're using the window.session storage. So if you look through your code and you find this, the window.localStorage instead of chrome.storage, then you can remove storage permission. So let's look at unlimited storage. In the documentation, it says here that it provides an unlimited quota for storing HTML5 client side data. And this doesn't quite say exactly when you need it, but it says here with this permission, the extension is limited to 5 MB of local storage. Now, what does that mean? This actually means literally chrome.storage.local. So you cannot use unlimited storage if you are using chrome.storage.sync. So one of the reasons that you may be getting rejected because you're trying to request unlimited storage is that you are using storage.sync, which does not have access to it. So another reason that your permission request for unlimited storage may be denied is because you are using local storage and unlimited storage does nothing for local storage. And unlimited storage also does nothing for chrome.storage.sync. Okay, so the only way you can use this is if you're using chrome.storage.local and it enables you to use this API without any limits. Let's look at an example so you can see what I'm referring to. Okay, so in our example, we want to remove this unlimited storage so you can see the natural limitation of the chrome.local.storage. So let's refresh this and I'm going to remove this and add it again. And let's look at the Okay, so here we're starting like this. We're going to this little script that we wrote adds 1 megabyte to the local storage, so you can see the limitation. Okay, so right now we are not with unlimited storage, so let's see how this works. Okay, we're adding 2.1, 3.1, 4.2. Okay, and here is where we exceed our quota, and then the local storage is also at full capacity. So let's go ahead and add unlimited storage to this again, so you can see how it works. Okay, let's refresh. Okay, so we are using 1 megabyte, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and this is where it would crash, and then like local storage already, you know, has its own limitations, so it doesn't see, as you can see, it doesn't affect local storage, the unlimited storage permission, but it does give chrome.storage.local more space. As you can see, this is a very powerful permission, so make sure you use it responsibly and clear out any unused data. You can easily fill out the user's hard drive with garbage, so don't be that guy. And this permission will most certainly raise red flags when you submit it to the Chrome Web Store. So I would expect at least one rejection for including this permission. If you really, really need to use this permission, clearly explain how it helps you accomplish your single purpose, and probably include the line in your code where you're clearing it and you're not just overusing your user's hard drive. Okay guys, that's it for this quick tip. On the next episode, we will see if we need other permissions. We will see how to add our privacy policy and what format it needs to be so that it's accepted by the Chrome Web Store, and many other tips on how to pass the reviewing process. If you like this video, please give us a like and subscribe, and leave us a comment to let us know that any other permissions that you're not sure about, and we can explain it further. I hope you and your extension are successful. Have a good one. Bye.